Welcome to SCP Read and Review, where I take a look at SCP objects that have been written for the wiki and are successful articles, and give kind of a bit of feedback to both the author and you to understand why the article works or doesn't work. Item number, SCP-3351. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. Areas where SCP-3351 has been determined to occur are to be cordoned off for that night. Personnel overseeing these areas are not to observe SCP-3351. Description: SCP-3351 is a phenomenon manifesting as a mist that occurs across the United Kingdom between the hours of 10 p.m. and 5 a.m. When a rainfall of at least 0.5 millimeters occurs over a lake, SCP-3351 will form over the lake and protrude a surrounding 2 meters. If disturbed, the mist will dissipate and no further anomalous properties will arise until suitable conditions occur again. When left undisturbed, the mist will form 5 artistic depictions of Earth, with exaggerated imagery of buildings and cities protruding from its surface. The first and fifth depict these cities consumed in fire. The second and fourth depict them overrun by massive, over-exaggerated flora and fauna. The central image depicts the cities intersected with numerous star-shaped objects, each ranging in size from 30% to 50% of the size of the globe. After approximately 2 hours, all 5 depictions will revert to a single image of Earth with no cities present. Exaggerated images of flora now take their place. The remaining mist gathers beneath the image to spell out the letters C-A-N. This lasts for 6 minutes before the mist loses all anomalous properties. The entire phenomenon occurs over a period of 125 minutes. The phenomenon is depicted on a non-anomalous plaque located on the shore of Ashworth Moor Reservoir in Greater Manchester, England, where SCP-3351 was first discovered. Individuals who witness SCP-3351 for at least 16 minutes will begin to experience short daily visual hallucinations involving different types of fauna, forestry, the ocean, and the sky at night. Hallucinations cease if the affected individual begins working in an occupational field related to nature preservation and conservation. So with SCP-3351, I really feel like I'm missing something, and I talked actually to the author specifically, I mentioned to the author that I felt like I was missing something, and Decibel, the person who wrote it, said that the article should stand on its own, though it does have references to prior works. The important thing I felt about this was that while I'm willing to accept that somehow I'm dense and that I'm missing something here, it really feels like there's a lot of stuff left hanging for anyone who hasn't read the prior works. In the comments, a lot of people speak strongly towards the final words of the SCP, where if you work in conservation or try to help the environment, basically, you stop having hallucinations based around the object, which I don't understand as a conclusion, since the object itself is already got a pretty environmental bent. It's not like this is some sort of new piece of information that I'm supposed to be shocked by. In fact, that direction feels like somewhere you would take the article naturally. You would just continue from that point. I mean, there's a lot here that goes unexplained, and I don't mean the author leaves it to your imagination. I mean, why isn't there more information in this file in-universe? We're allowed to have certain willing suspension of disbelief, but here we've got some serious issues that are never really investigated. When we talk about the article standing on its own, I have to ask, what is the significance of the letters C-A-N in the article itself? What is the significance of Ashworth Moor Reservoir? Is that just a place that's been inserted at random? And how detailed are these artistic representations of Earth? How do we know they're Earth and not some other planet? There's no detail really given. It just says they are of Earth and you're supposed to accept it. And normally I'm willing to excuse little Easter eggs, like in this particular case. Like, this article is a fifthist article and you might not fully understand that. But when you look at stuff like there's 5 Earths and 0.5 millimeters of rain and 5 a.m. and 5 cubed minutes of manifestation, the SCP Foundation didn't notice any of that, and they didn't think maybe all these mentions of 5 might have something to do with the fifthist church. They didn't feel like that was worth mentioning in the article itself. While this article is impeccably written, I should say, and Decibel is a great author, and I think it has some incredible potential, it doesn't capitalize on that potential. And okay, I should make this clear. I don't need every article to be a 3,000-word monster, but something this short? You shouldn't include so many unfired guns. There's a lot of details in here that are not expanded upon, and if you're not going to expand on them, you shouldn't include them. It's very, very basic writing advice there. When I got to the end of this, I was just left unsatisfied with the article, and I had to downvote. But let me know what you thought in the comments down below. Please subscribe, like, and share with your friends. And if you like this particular type of content, let me know, and I will see about doing more of these in the future. Thank you very much, and you'll hear me in the next video.